Hi, I'm Jamie Ford, and one of my favorite books is Deathbird Stories by Harlan Ellison. I discovered Deathbird Stories in the library of my junior high. It's a book that really had no business being there. It's pretty out there for even contemporary audiences, but I think there was probably some hippie librarian that wanted to expand our minds. There was a lot of just dark, gratuitous everything, and for a seventh grader, it was kind of like stumbling onto the Playboy collection under your dad's bed, except it was in a literary way. But the writing was brilliant, and the fact that it instantly was removed from our library made all of us want to read it even more. Harlan Ellison's work is all didactical, it's all self-taught, and it has a real raw essence to it. And my background is in art and design, and so I don't have an MFA in creative writing. You know, I have a background in art, so for me, you know, a dangling participle is part of the male anatomy. So as a self-taught writer, seeing something that was that raw, that honest, and that really unforgiving in a literary way was amazing. It's a book that totally holds up. Yeah, it's been translated into a bazillion languages. I just read it last year, just because I had to go back and see if I liked it as much, and I like it more now that I'm a published author. It's a book that's really dark. It's a bunch of short stories, but there's a moment in there that's really tender, and it's within a short story. There's this little moment about Harlan when he was a kid and had his dog, his neighbor had his dog put to sleep, and talks about him sneaking into his neighbor's yard and stealing a rug off of his neighbor's clothesline and burying that in lieu of his dog. And it's very sentimental and sweet, and it's this little gem in this very dark story. It's one of those moments that as the poet Derek Brown would say, it feels the way cotton candy tastes.